Hi, I'm Lauren, and today I have the opportunity to show you in detail one of our design gems, the all-new Superb. And who better to describe the beauty of the car than its creator?
Thank you very much for this nice introduction of the car. I think the designers put a lot of work on this, and it shows off.
It really does.
I will explain now a little bit about the front of the Superb. First of all, you see this two lines here. This is what we call the inverse power dome. And then it creates also this kind of line, this dip into the grille. And you see also that all these elements are not in chrome anymore. They're in a different color, which we call UDC, you need dark chrome. It's much more sustainable than chrome, and it looks also gorgeous, looks more modern. So, but then also we have the grille, and we're connecting the headlights right to the grille. So we have a strong brand and product identity on the car. What makes the brand identity is that we always be symmetrical, yeah? And we're also showing a lot of width, yeah? Spaciousness. That's why we pull the dashboard in the doors like this. And we have a lot of lines that emphasize this as well, yeah? Also, this hidden vents here, they're very nice because this makes this, again, the product. This is especially for the Superb we developed this. And this gives a very strong character to the car.
I really love the practicality of the design and the elegance of the leather as well as the door handles.
Yeah, the door handles are quite nice. They also, by the way, in UDC.
Just like the front of the car.
Right. Okay, well, talking about this door handle is on this very important line that you see here, this crease line that runs from the front headlight to the rear light. It is everything connecting the car with the other door handle. It makes a nice line and gives the car really length. This is also what we want to approach with this car. Length is also space again, yeah? But what I really like, Lauren, is this flow line, as we call this. It's the A-post, starts from here, over the roof line, and then goes into the C-post and all the way back to the trunk, yeah? And this is a very distinctive line because this makes the car very dynamic and very elegant, yeah?
I love the beautiful details that you use to push the design of all of the cars further.
So when you look at this taillight, Lauren, you see that we have also pretty much put these details in. This segmentation is very nice. We can hide the shut line on the side. We have this illuminated fingers on the side of the car. It's really great and astonishing. And by the way, also we have good aerodynamics because of this aerodynamic feature that we see also here in the line. Yeah? So everything pays into this looking modern and very really sophisticated.
Now, I'm wondering one thing. How much of a design challenge was it to turn a beautifully balanced limousine silhouette into a practical combi?
The only thing that we have to take over for the limo was the taillights, and I think we managed very well to integrate this there. The combi, it's more elegant, it's a bit more sporty, but also at the same time it's very practical with the rear, with the low loading height and the width. I think this is a typical Škoda, and also it carried also the nice element like the Škoda lettering in UDC there. I think it's a great looking car also from the rear. The combi is a very nice brother of the limo.
Okay, Oliver, now I've got a personal question for you. Which of the two is your favorite?
Whoa, Laura, that's a tricky question, I have to say. I mean, it's like asking parents what is their favorite child. I would leave this to the customers. They can choose, we have a good offer. Škoda.